Hello and welcome to another video with me, Christian Rauchenwald. In today's video, we are going to take a look at double opt-in, what it is, what it means for your business, and if you actually need it. And at the end, I'm going to show you how you can set it up in the most efficient way possible. Now let's start with what is double opt-in. Double opt-in is a process where somebody would visit your website or your funnel and they opt into your email list. So they provide their email and submit a form, which then adds them to one of your email lists. Now, theoretically, you would start sending them your marketing emails or follow-up sequence, but with a double opt-in, before doing that, you will actually send them an email that asks them to click on a link or a button to confirm their subscription. Now, the benefit of this approach is clearly that you make sure that only users that really want to get your emails actually end up receiving your emails. However, the downside also is that sometimes users forget or just miss your confirmation email. So they think they've opted in, but then they don't notice that confirmation email, they don't confirm the subscription, and they do not receive your follow-up email campaign, which reduces the success of your email marketing efforts because you will not be able to reach as many people as you would without using a double opt-in. Now the question is, why would we use a double opt-in at all if it actually can have a negative impact on our business? Now I want to be perfectly clear here. I'm not a lawyer, so the information I'm providing you with is based on my own opinion and personal experience. If you want to be 100% certain that it's still accurate, I encourage you to seek legal counsel for that matter. Now, one of the reasons why we would need a double opt-in would be because of legal regulations or local law that applies. There's a common misconception that people think there is a law within Europe that actually states that you have to use double opt-in, but that's not very precise. In fact, some European states have a regulation that requires you to be able to prove that a subscriber of your newsletter or your follow-up email campaigns provided you with consent to receiving those emails. And the only way to actually get that consent, and also in a way that you can later prove it, is by using a double opt-in. So it's not necessarily that the double opt-in is required, but that you need to be able to prove in certain countries within Europe and maybe in other countries on this planet as well, that the user consented to receiving marketing emails or newsletters from you. Now, considering those two things, so the fact that we know that double opt-in actually can harm our success rate with our email marketing efforts, and the fact that in some countries it may be the only way to stay fully compliant with the local law, you would actually need to use double opt-in on all your projects. Now, you may be saying, oh, my business is within the US and here the laws are different, but you would be wrong, because as soon as one person from Europe enters your website or funnel where they are able to subscribe to your newsletter, that user would need to be presented with a double opt-in. Now, as it stands, if you really want to be fully compliant, you would set up all your emails with a double opt-in. And while for sure not everybody that opts into your newsletter or follow-up funnels will also confirm the subscription to receive the follow-up email campaigns, and therefore the number of people that you will be able to reach with your marketing efforts will be smaller, the people that actively gave you consent to do so are probably the better audience. Now, one last thing that's worth mentioning here, your double opt-in email cannot contain any marketing content. So if you have a footer that promotes some of your courses, trainings, products, or whatever in all your regular emails, your double opt-in email actually is not allowed to have that. So it has to be more or less a very short email that pretty much just points out, thanks for opting in order to confirm your subscription to our newsletter, please click on the button below. Now I get that the information I shared with you so far may be a little bit a bummer because you now think you'll have to change all your email marketing campaigns and use double opt-in in all of your emails, but I'm gonna show you a way, as promised, how you can do a double opt-in only for the countries where you actually need it without affecting all the other countries and without working with different funnels or opt-in pages per country and so on. And in order to do that in the easiest way possible, we are going active campaign. Now, what I'm going to show you right now may also in some way be possible with other autoresponders out there. So if you're unable to do the same in your autoresponder, you'll either will need to find another workaround, like working with different opt-in pages per country, or simply switch your autoresponder. Now, there's many reasons why we personally love ActiveCampaign. what I'm going to show you in a second is just one of them. Now here we are with an active campaign and we're currently on our list screen, and I'm going to start by creating a new list here and we call it demo double opt-in, and I'm going to give it a domain for that list, democfpowerscripts.com, and the description is going to say this is a demo. I'm going to click add to create that new list, and with that we have a new list. Now that we have the list in place, the next step is going to automations, where we actually set up our follow-up automations, and I'm going to create a new automation by clicking on create an automation and selecting start from scratch and continue. That's going to take a moment for ActiveCampaign to load up that new automation, and it's going to start by asking us what we want to use as a trigger. You have many options here as you can see, but we are going to pick the most basic one, and the most common one is subscribes to a list. So whenever somebody subscribes to our demo double opt-in list, we want to run this automation. And the first thing we want to do is we want to send them an email, and we're going to click on create email, and I'm going to call this email double opt-in and click on create. Now this is automatically going to open the email editor. I'm going to pick a template here and I'm going to add a subject line, action required, please confirm your subscription. And I'm going to change the sender's address to info@christianrauchenwald.com and click on continue. Now ActiveCampaign is going to create that email, and we're going to in the next step see the email editor to actually change the content of that email. And this is where you would remove all the marketing content from the footer, which I'm not going to do right now, and adjust the placeholder text here to something like please confirm. And here we're going to say confirm subscription. Now you would ideally link that button or text link here to a thank you page that says thank you for confirming your subscription. For the purpose of this demo, I'm just going to link it to demo.cfpowerscripts.com, and I'm going to click on next and on finish to actually save that new email. Now I didn't adjust the pre-header text, I didn't remove the marketing content from the footer and so on. That's all something that you would need to do as well for this double opt-in email, but for the purpose of that demo, it's not necessary. Now back in the automation setup, I'm gonna click on save, and we have our first email in place. Now with those two pieces in place, so the trigger that when somebody subscribes to our demo double opt-in list and our double opt-in email, every subscriber that joins our list would receive the double opt-in email, and that's something we want to avoid. So for that, before our double opt-in email, we're gonna click on the plus icon and we're gonna go to conditions and add an if else condition. And we're going to select our condition by saying geography country is, and here we have multiple options. Now, if you're very precise, you would research which countries currently require a double opt-in. And you would, for example, say Germany requires one. So you look for Germany, or geography country equals, for example, France, and so on. And you would have to list all the countries that require a double opt-in. If you want to simplify it a little bit, you could just say if country is European Union and click on add. Now, this will create this if else element and basically split your list. Now what's happening here is when somebody subscribes to the demo double opt-in list, ActiveCampaign is going to check if the user is within the European Union. And if yes, it's going to send the double opt-in email. And if no, it's going to do whatever we set up here. Now, before we worry about the part that we set up here, which will then be our actual follow-up campaign, so the emails that we want to send users to get them to convert or buy or sign up or reach out, we still have one more thing to do. After our double opt-in email, we need to click on plus and we need to go to conditions and select the wait element. But instead of waiting for a specific period of time, we are going to wait until a specific condition is met. And as a condition, we are going to select actions has clicked on link from our double opt-in email. And now we should see our demo.cfpowerscripts.com link. I still can't see it here, but we can also just type here and it will search through all the links. And here we go. So we select that link and we say save. Last but not least, for the wait element, you can define a time limit. So you could limit the amount of time the user has to actually confirm his subscription. If you set no time limit, the user could get the confirmation email and confirm the subscription a year from now, and only then would continue with the marketing email flow. So usually it makes sense to simply have no time limit in place. Now with that in place, what's going to happen now is when somebody subscribes, Active Campaign is going to check if they are from within the European Union or not. If yes, they're going to receive the double opt-in email, and it's going to wait until they click on the confirmation link, which is going to be logged in their profile within Active Campaign, providing you with the proof that they gave you consent. Or if they're not from within the European Union, it would continue here. Now here you would set up your first marketing email by clicking on plus, sending options, send email, and create a new email, which you can then call whatever you want. For example, welcome to our newsletter. And again, you will need to pick an email template, enter a subject line, click on continue, actually create your email template. So the text it should say, all the elements that should be in there, click on next and click on finish to have your first marketing email in place. Now back in the automation screen, all you have to do is click on save and we'll have our welcome email here. Now you're probably wondering how you get people that confirmed their subscription to also receive that welcome email now. And don't worry, you don't have to set up all your email twice. There's a simple way how you can do that with Active Campaign. Now, what we want to do is whenever somebody clicked on that link, we actually want to also continue with the welcome email. So we're going to click on the plus icon below our wait element, and we go to conditions workflow and select the go to action and simply drag and drop that green point to the welcome email. Now, what happens again is when somebody subscribes to the list, if they are from within Europe, it's going to send the double opt-in email. And once they clicked on that link, within a couple of minutes, in my test, it's between 5 and 10 minutes after they clicked on the link, it will send them the first email here. If somebody opts in from outside of Europe, it will immediately send them that first welcome email. And then you can simply continue here with your actual follow-up campaign by adding a wait element, wait for example 1 day, and adding your next email in the series. I also recommend that you check out the video that I published recently about how you can increase your email opening rates by 50% roughly. You can do so by clicking on the card in the top right corner or checking the link in the description below. Now, if you're not yet using Active Campaign or if you're not convinced that it's worth switching to Active Campaign, I also recommend that you check out that video because it will show you a second reason why I personally love Active Campaign over other autoresponders out there. And if you're on the fence or even if you have decided that you want to give Active Campaign a try, you can do so by checking the first comment or the description down below, and you will find a link to start your personal free 14-day trial with Active Campaign so you can actually benefit from Active Campaign's amazing automation editor. Now, once you're done with building your automation, there are two more steps that you need to do. The first one is give it a name, like for example, double opt-in or my free lead magnet, and click on save. And the last thing is to actually activate it. Now, obviously, once you have all that in place, you still need to get people on your email list by, for example, connecting your ClickFunnels account with your Active Campaign account and setting up the integration to add people to your list in Active Campaign. But that's beyond the scope of that video. If you need help with that, simply leave a comment down below. That's it. That's almost all there is to know about double opt-in, why you need to use it, in which cases you need to use it, and how you can use Active Campaign to get the most out of it by only using it when you really need to use it. Now, don't forget, if you were able to take anything positive away from that video, give it a thumbs up so I know that the content we are providing you with is actually valuable to you. If you have any questions whatsoever, leave a comment down below. And to give Active Campaign a try, check the link in the description down below or the link in the first comment down below. Thanks for watching. See you next week with another video. Till then, bye-bye.